Once upon a time, reading was pretty much the only entertainment option. But in the modern day, with almost endless distractions, you've got to be picky about your reading list. If you're trying to read some of the best books of all time, start with this list of must-read books and crack open a masterpiece. 1. To Kill a Mockingbird. By Harper Lee. It's not every day that a debut novel wins the Pulitzer Prize for fiction and remains a crowd favorite for decades, but Harper Lee's masterpiece did. This masterfully written story brings readers to a small southern town, dealing with overt racism in a spectacular legal trial, told through the eyes of a precocious 6-year-old girl being raised by her ethically driven, thoughtful father. Lee exhibits her masterful craft in the realistic, brilliant point of view of Scout and the symbolism she gave the book without sacrificing readability. This is a novel that's easily accessible but equally rich with humor, drama, and suspense. 2. Pride and Prejudice. By Jane Austen. You can enjoy Pride and Prejudice purely as a romantic tale, following the smart, independent Elizabeth Bennet as she navigates two suitors. One charming but ultimately unreliable and the other initially boorish, but later revealed to be, well, Mr. Darcy, sigh. Or you can read it within the context of early 19th century social mores and conventions, particularly with the dangers of marriage and pregnancy for young women at the time. Or you can appreciate it for Austen's sharp, often hilariously scathing takedowns of society, much of which remains surprisingly applicable in the modern age. Timeless and entertaining, if you have never read an Austen novel before, start with this one. 3. 100 Years of Solitude. By Gabriel Garcia Marquez. There's a short list of novels that defined a genre and became inextricably tied to it. 100 Years of Solitude is often regarded as one of the first true books written in the magical realist style, as well as one of the most important Latin American novels ever published. It tells the story of a man who flees Colombia and founds a city based on his own perceptions of the universe, and the subsequent generations of his family who suffer endlessly due to their own limitations. It combines historical fact with fantastic impossibility in an intensely personal point of view, concerned with the issues of an entire culture. If you're unfamiliar with magical realism and want a crash course, this is the perfect place to start. 4. Don Quixote. By Penguin Sessix. Published in 1605, this may be the first novel, in the modern sense of the word, ever written. An immediate success, Cervantes's masterpiece continues to influence writers today, and its central image of a deluded old man tilting at windmills remains embedded in popular culture, but there's so much more to this must-read book than its comedy, thought it is legitimately hilarious. Don Quixote's themes of futility, mortality, and the corruption of supposed noble behavior remain powerful. Even modern readers will find the story to be frequently amusing, though it may leave them saddened by the perceived cruelty of a chaotic universe. 5. 1984. By George Orwell's. 1984 is a novel that never seems to age. Its elegant language to its haunting imagery of oppression and mind control, Orwell's seminal work, always seems to be describing a near-future dystopia that's just around the corner. The tragic story follows Winston Smith, a man who lives in a future England where truth has become meaningless and love has become a force for evil. With frequent references in pop culture to the thought police, 1984 is not just about the dangers of oppressive political regimes, but also the fundamental weakness within us all. The book's impact is so great that it has supplied most of the vocabulary we use when discussing totalitarian states, and more than 70 years after its publication, it still has plenty to teach us about an individual's role in society. Please hit a like button and subscribe this channel if you love books. Now let's hear back to our list. 6. Great Expectations. By Charles Dickens. Some novels get on must-read lists because of stylistic invention or literary and thematic complexity. But others, like Great Expectations, get on these lists for the sheer achievement in storytelling. It's one of two Dickens novels to be narrated entirely in the first person, the other being his other novel about an orphan's life titled David Copperfield, and is clearly the product of an artist completely in control of his powers. Telling the story of an orphan named Pip as he makes his way through life, Dickens effortlessly explores universal themes of love, loss, tragedy, and regret. For every reader, there is something in this story that will resonate and remind them of their own life, and after reading it, a slew of cultural references you've been missing will suddenly click into place, like Miss Havisham and her rotting dress. 7. Catch 22. By Joseph Heller. Heller's 1961 novel perfectly captures that uncanny sense that the modern world is no fit place for human beings. Using subtle repetitions, an unreliable sense of time, and absurdity ratcheted up to extreme proportions, his story of soldiers and pilots in World War II masks its fundamental horror in hilarious scenarios. The central hilarity is, of course, the titular catch, which states that any pilot who wants to avoid extreme danger must merely prove that they are crazy to avoid missions, but being concerned for your safety proves you're rational, so the moment you express it, you can't be crazy, and thus have to fly. Dark, profound, and consistently funny, the novel's reputation has grown steadily since publication, making it an easy choice for a list of must-read books. 8. Frankenstein. By Mary Shelley. One of the first science fiction novels ever written, Shelley's masterpiece remains legitimately unsettling and often misunderstood. Shelley pioneered many of the tropes and conventions used in the genre today during a cold, dark summer vacation to Switzerland. It was, unbeknownst to her and her companions, in the aftermath of one of the worst volcanic eruptions in history. The darkness and cold of the vacation helped inspire the novel. Its real trick is somehow making its terrifying monster the true protagonist and hero of the story, even as it's scaring the pants off of you. There's a reason this novel continues to be adapted, remixed, and reinvented. Frankenstein's monster obviously remains an iconic invention, but you must read the book to truly understand why. 9. The Handmaid's Tale. By Margaret Atwood. Any list of must-read books has to include Atwood's brilliant work of feminist dystopia. While film and television adaptations have captured the tone and basic story, reading the novel remains the ideal way to experience the tale of Offred, a woman subjugated, legally raped, and forced to make impossible decisions in a near-future America, ruled by a horrifying fundamentalist religious cult, in the wake of a fertility collapse. The sense of quiet fury bubbling under Offred's story is powerful, and the novel's deep exploration of how both men and women support and enable a misogynistic society asks uncomfortable questions and offers few easy answers. Like 1984 before it, The Handmaid's Tale always seems to be describing a future that's uncomfortably close to being real. 10. A Tree Grows in Brooklyn. By Betty Smith. Set in Brooklyn in the early 20th century, this American classic follows a poor family living in a tenement and struggling to make their way. Beautifully written, not only does this novel capture what life was like at a particular moment in history, when the United States was emerging as a world power and city life began to dominate the country, it also serves as a powerful motivational experience. The central theme of Francie Nolan and her family's story is one of tenacity as they refuse to give up. It's a wonderfully old-fashioned story that still has the power to move and inspire. 11. The Color Purple. By Alice Walker. This Pulitzer Prize-winning novel explores the brutal and violent lives of two African-American women in 1930s Georgia. Sisters Celia and Nettie. The horrors inflicted on the women by both a racist system and men in general are chilling. While there are perpetual efforts to have the book banned for its depictions of rape, homosexuality, and violence, it's precisely those unflinching depictions that make this novel a must-read and, in the end, an inspiring and hopeful story of triumph over the worst that humanity can do to each other. 12. Anna Karenina. By Anna Karenina. If you're going to read just one big Russian novel, make it this one. There's so much going on in Tolstoy's novel it almost vibrates with the energy it contains, even during the long stretches where characters discuss farming and economics. The story focuses on an aristocratic woman who leaves her privileged, comfortable position in life to pursue what she thinks is true love. It touches on many universal themes modern readers will feel deeply, including the pressure that society puts on all of us to play the role we've been given. The complexity of the characters and their relationships defies easy categorization, but every page is almost a novel unto itself. 13. Never Let Me Go. By Kazuo Ishiguro. While on the surface, this beautiful, elegiac tale tells the story of three friends growing up at a boarding school, who discover their lives have a secret and devastating purpose, Never Let Me Go is really a thoughtful rumination on mortality. Ishiguro uses the sci-fi tropes of the story to explore how time changes us, having witnesses to our lives is important, and what truly makes someone human. Despite its preoccupation with death, the novel is a brilliant celebration of life, and how joy and purpose is really the default setting for being alive. 14. Things Fall Apart. By Chinua Achebe. This classic Nigerian novel was one of the first works of African literature to get worldwide attention, and remains a powerful exploration of the effects of colonialism and modernity. Set in a fictional Nigerian village and narrated by Okonkwo, a local wrestling champion, the story spans decades as tragedy drives Okonkwo's family into exile, and they find the village greatly changed by the influence of Christian missionaries when they return. Very few novels critically explore the arrogance and danger of imposing cultural views on people, but Achebe does so with wit, intelligence, and a firm grasp of drama that remains remarkable. 15. Beloved. By Toni Morrison. Morrison's incredible novel straddles horror and history, telling the story of Seed, an escaped enslaved woman who murdered her youngest daughter, rather than let her live in slavery. Years later, Seed believes she is haunted by the girl's spirit, a young woman called Beloved. Seethe's tortured attempt to spare her children the horrors she experienced is rendered with powerful poetic force, making it a terrifying read that is almost essential for anyone who wants to have some small understanding of the true ravages of slavery and historical memory, or simply to experience one of the best novels ever written. Congrats, you are a natural born reader. Now, without wasting any time, hit the like button and subscribe this channel now. 16. Lolita. By Vladimir Nabokov. Often decried as perverse and obscene, Nabokov's story of a pedophile who obsesses over and ultimately destroys a young girl is also one of the greatest character studies ever achieved. Humbert Humbert is about as unreliable a narrator as you can find, making his darkly cheerful story of marrying Lolita's mother so he can seduce her preteen daughter more revealing than if it had been told in a more factual way. You're supposed to despise Humbert and his transparent attempts to paint himself the victim, but the novel's true trick is how easily it seduces you and pulls you into this absolutely horrifying story. Lolita is a rare book that can create a whirlwind of emotions. 17. The Murder of Roger Ackroyd. By Christie. In a world where plot twist is part of our everyday slang, it's easy to forget how powerful this book was in its time. Christie took one of her precise, elegant mysteries and injected into it a twist and narrative device, so bonkers it still makes people angry today, but she pulled it off, elevating it above the rest of her novels. To describe the trick is to spoil it, of course, but what we can say about it is that Christie weaponizes one of the most fundamental assumptions a reader can make against them, and it's glorious. 18. The Lord of the Rings. By J.R.R. Tolkien. Books that totally define a genre are few and far between, but epic fantasy continues to be dominated by Tolkien's masterpiece. The story of humble hobbits who undertake a dangerous mission to carry a potent evil talisman, the titular One Ring, to rule them all into the dark stronghold of Sauron, the ring's creator, is so sewn into our pop culture, you probably recognize the details, even if you've never read the books. Tolkien didn't just tell an epic story of good versus evil, he crafted an entire universe in Middle-earth, complete with lush, detailed history and fully realized, fleshed-out characters. Writers have been following his lead ever since, and even today's postmodern epic fantasies are discussed in relation to how much they subvert or ignore Tolkien. 19. My Brilliant Friend. By Elena Ferrante. With debates about her true identity, Ferrante created both a story and a series that is equally entertaining and questioning. My Brilliant Friend begins the four-book series that tracks the lives of two lifelong friends from their childhood in Naples throughout their seventh decade. The story and series remain one of the best explorations of female friendship ever put to paper. It's also a dramatic story, filled with plot twists and riveting surprises, moments of intense emotion, and plenty of mystery. The two friends, Lila and Elena, are rendered in so much rich detail they become real in a way many characters, even great characters, fail to, and the story offers a glimpse of a life and neighborhood now long gone. Timeless and classic already, this novel will likely be on lists like this one for the foreseeable future. 20. Harry Potter. The Complete Collection, 1-7. By J.K. Rowling. The Harry Potter books and associated films, plays, and other media have thoroughly transcended genre and even literature to become cultural institutions. While the original novels remain incredible achievements of world-building and storytelling, what truly sets them apart is Rowling's unerring grasp of character. Her young wizards realistically grow and evolve as the story spins out, maturing into people with believable inner lives, even as they use magic to fight epic battles and struggle to save the world. These books are more than just great examples of fantasy literature, as the combination of myth-making and exploration of character makes a story firmly rooted in the impossible feel real.